In this video lecture, you will learn how to process the data before applying the linear regression algorithm to predict the movement of the market. Data pre-processing is a data mining technique used to clean raw data. Real-world data, or raw data, is often incomplete, inconsistent, and likely to contain errors. Data pre-processing is a proven method of resolving such issues. It increases the performance of an algorithm. The phrase garbage in, garbage out is particularly applicable to machine learning and data mining. Unless the training model is fed with pre-processed data, the outputs of the model will be inconsistent. Quality decisions are based on quality data. Duplicate or missing data may result in misleading trading signals. Before we start with pre-processing the fetched data, we create three new datasets, namely X, YU, and YD. X contains the open price, three moving averages, and it also stores entries in the columns OD, OL, and CORE, from the data frame DF. YU and YD are vectors storing the values under the headers STD underscore U, and STD underscore D, in the data frame DF respectively, which have been defined earlier. X, YU and YD will be further split into two train and test sets. The linear regression model along with hyperparameters, a concept that would be covered later in this course, is used to identify the parameters best suited for the model. The most common type of error seen in financial data is the presence of non-numerical data entries, or NaN or not a number. A financial dataset contains numerical data for each of the column headers, except for the date field, which stores all the trading dates for the particular security. The S&P 500 index in our model, we instantiate the imputer function using the variable imp, which helps in identifying and replacing missing values. Imp will be called later through the pipeline function, using steps to execute the data pre-processing. This will be discussed in more detail in the upcoming units. The imputer function takes the first argument as the type of missing value to be replaced. In this case, we have represented NaN in this field, as we are looking to replace the non-numerical values. The next argument to be entered is the strategy to be used for replacing the NaN values. We could either choose the mean, median, or most frequent value of the dataset. The mean is used when we do not want to change the average of the column, but in doing so the distribution of the variable can get severely distorted, leading to underestimating the standard deviation, which could result in erroneous outputs. The median can also be used to replace the missing values. This would lead to changing the mean of the data. In this model, we use the most frequently appearing data entry, which is the mode of the column being checked for the missing data. This is done by passing most underscore frequent in the strategy field of the imputer function. Next, we standardize the dataset by centering and scaling it. Centering is done to reduce the mean value of the data to zero. Scaling refers to dividing each entry by the standard deviation of the data. This results in transforming the standard deviation of the data to be 1. It is highly recommended to standardize the data for predictive models. For linear regression, which you will learn later in the course, the method for finding the best parameters is most efficient. When the coefficients of the regression equation have similar magnitudes, we define the steps to be implemented in sequential order, starting with the imputation, followed by standardizing the data using the standard scalar function, and finally calling the linear regression function.